Good morning, dear students. How are you doing all? I'm sure you are doing well. So, welcome back to our lesson that is chemical reactions and equations. This is the first lesson from chemistry of class 10. Okay. So, various topics related to the lesson we have completed. What are those? The first is how to balance the chemical reaction. Balancing of chemical reaction step by step we have learned. Along with it, we have tried to make you to understand how to write the states of matter, then temperature and the catalyst used in it. So step by step, the chemical reaction, balancing chemical reaction we have learned. After it, we have gone for the types of chemical reaction. Various kinds of chemical reactions we have learned, that is combination reaction, the uses of combination reaction in our day-to-day life. After it, we have gone for the decomposition reaction. Decomposition reaction means what? Decomposing or splitting one chemical compound into two to three different kinds of compound. That is decomposition reaction we have gone. There are three kinds of decomposition reaction. That is thermal decomposition reaction. This decomposition reaction takes place in presence of heat. Then electrolytic decomposition reaction means electrolysis of water we have seen. After it, photochemical decomposition reactions means silver chloride, if we try to take into the sunlight, then chlorine gas goes off or releases into the atmosphere and we get a silver. So that those reactions we have completed. After it, the displacement reaction we have seen. Displacement reaction means not simply highly reactive metal is displaced by least reactive metal according to the reactive. We can know that highly reactive metal is replaced by less reactive metal. So displacement reaction we have seen. After it, double displacement reaction we have seen. In this double displacement reaction, what happens? Only the ion exchange is taking place. Only ion exchange is taking place into the double displacement reaction we have seen. In a double displacement reaction, there is one subtype of chemical reaction we have seen, that is precipitation reaction. Means whenever two chemicals are mixing together, the insoluble solid residue is remaining or settling down into the chemical reaction. That insoluble solid residue is called as a precipitate. So such reactions are called as a precipitation reaction. That also we have tried to cover. After it, oxidation reaction and reduction reaction also we have tried to complete. Oxidation means what? Gaining of oxygen, losing of hydrogen and loss of electron is also termed as a oxidation reaction. After it, reduction reaction we have gone for. Reduction reaction means what? Gaining of hydrogen, loss of oxygen and gaining of electron will be said to be reduction reaction. As well as the concept of oxidizing agent and reducing agent also we have gone for. As well as when simultaneously oxidation and reduction reaction is taking place, that is called as an oxidation reduction reaction or redox reaction. So this is all about the lesson which we have tried to cover in this lesson. Okay, these are the various topics we try to cover in this lesson. So we have reached to the last topic of this lesson, that is effects of oxidation in everyday life. See your students, there are damaging effects of oxidation in our day-to-day life. How damaging effects? Means if oxidation will take place for the metals, then it is damaging the metal, or that it is termed as a corrosion. If oxidation will take place for the metal, then it is called as a corrosion. Okay, this is the damaging effect of oxidation on the metal. So there are two effects. If metals comes in the contact with atmospheric oxygen, then it is damaging. And when the food which contains oil and fat, if it will come in the contact with the atmospheric oxygen, then also it is damaging our food material. And that process is called as a rancidity. So we talk about the second process, that is rancidity. So these two processes are the effects of oxidation in everyday life, and this Okay. the ships, railings are there, everywhere we use railings, then railway tracks are undergoing, then ships, then bridges, are enormous amount of money required for the prevention of corrosion every year. So this is actually a money gaining process. Every year we have to use some prevention techniques to for avoiding them from the corrosion. What is that? Some techniques we have learned about in our third lesson, that are oiling, then painting, then galvanizing, and galvanizing them also can be greasing also, as well as alloying also technique we can utilize for the same. So here, this is the damaging effect of oxidation for the metal, and that is called as a corrosion that I have tried to cover here. Now we will go for the next topic, that is rancidity. What is the rancidity? See students, what happens whenever any food material, which the leftover food material or any fresh food material, whenever it comes in contact with the atmospheric oxygen, but that food material should contain fats and oils. If the food material containing fats and oils, if we come in the contact with the atmospheric oxygen, then that food will become rancid, and that process is called as a rancidity. Rancid food means what? That food will get a unpleasant smell. That food will get a unpleasant smell and taste too. It does not taste good like fresh food. This sour and stale taste is coming for it. Okay, and the smell is unpleasant. It's not good for our health even. Okay, so this is called as a rancidity. And forming means whenever the food material which contains fats and oil comes in the contact with the atmospheric oxygen and damaging the food, that is called as a rancidity. Okay, and the food becomes rancid. The food becomes rancid means what? It gives us an unpleasant smell and the taste. The food becomes stale and the soury nature, which is not fit for our usage. We cannot consume such kind of food. So this is actually a damaging effect on the food of the oxidation process. So here we have completed the effects of the damaging effects of oxidation on the food. So if there are the effects, then we have some preventions also. There are some preventive methods or measures also to be safe from the rancid food. What are those? There are actually four kinds of processes, okay, through which we can avoid the process of rancidity. What is that? The first process is, we can use the antioxidants into the food packets or into the food material which contains oil and the fats. The antioxidants we can use. These antioxidants, what they would do? These antioxidants would break the contact between the food material and the oxygen. Okay, means these antioxidants will not allow the food to become rancid. So there are two antioxidants that we can utilize to make the food free from the rancidity. There is of food, that is addition of unreactive the refrigerator. So what we do, we keep our food, leftover food, into the refrigerator to remain a fresh. But we cannot completely prevent the process of transiting. We can just slower down the process of transiting into the fresh.